Hey everyone, I'm here today to talk to you about allusions and our weave-in for our personal memoir draft. An allusion is a reference within a piece of writing to something of historical, literary, cultural significance. When you reference another author's short story, or if you reference a famous movie, or you reference a famous person from history in a historical event in your own work, it can help describe a situation or an emotion to a reader in an interesting way. A cultural allusion is whenever you're weaving in something from your own culture to help describe a situation, an event, an emotion, etc. So, today we're going to explore some pieces of culture, of my culture from the 90s and your culture from the 2000s, and then we're going to be weaving them into our drafts to create some interesting descriptions. So, for the cultural allusions, you're going to reference specific movies, TV shows, people, objects, clothing, sayings that are relevant to your time period within your work. So I'm going to start by sharing some things that are relevant to me from my culture of the 90s, and then you guys are going to be looking at some things that are culturally important to you, brainstorming with a graphic organizer, coming up with a list of as many different cultural pieces as you can, and then weaving them into your drafts as analogies, comparisons. So, first, I'm going to share some things with a video, just a blend of things from the 90s, music that was really popular when I was in middle school, some different TV scenes, some different objects that were important in the 90s, and then also I have a cultural allusion box I'm going to share with you as well.
Are y'all ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain!
I can't hear you!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Cultural allusions. This is my box of cultural allusions. There's a lot of really cool things in here. This is my binder from middle school of, are you ready? Pokemon cards. If I referenced this in my memoir, it would be a cultural allusion. I could say it was as exciting as getting a Charizard, holographic Charizard. That would be a cultural allusion. Also in my box, I have this like Koosh slingshot. These are really popular back in the 90s. If I incorporated like it shot across the room as fast as a Koosh ball slingshot, then that would be a cultural illusion. Pogs! Guys, pogs are like little round cardboards. Like this is from Charlie Brown. And like, you would collect these pogs. They were super cool. You just collect them. Crazy bows, go-go's. Guys, these are like little plastic things that you would collect and you would basically do bowling with them. So I would use these in a cultural illusion of my own. You would do something like maybe squinkies, right? Things from your time period. So these are just some things in my cultural illusion box that are really cool to me. Now that's what I call music. Reptar. So think of some things that are interesting to you and culturally significant to you on your graphic organizer. So here's the graphic organizer that you are going to be using to collect important things from your culture. This is not just this year. This is your entire childhood growing up. You're going to pack these boxes with significant people, objects, songs, and artists. And I was like, baby, 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 oh. Clothing, movies and TV shows, and phrases and sayings. So today's task is to pack these boxes. We'll discuss what you guys came up with, and then tomorrow you'll be taking these and you'll be crafting 3 different cultural illusions in your Google Draft, and you'll be color coding them purple using an analogy to compare something in your memoir with a piece of cultural illusion. So this is in the last page of your planning guide, and this here shows what you're weaving in, how you're color coding it, and what our learning target is for this particular activity. Okay, enjoy!